There are a lot of ways of doing this. There are probably better ways of doing this, but this is the way I do it. First, we want to point light near our object. I'm giving it 10,000 watts. Make sure you're using EV. Check bloom. Under shadows, make these both as big as they can be. Check high bit depth. Uncheck soft shadows. In your light properties, check contact shadows. In the shading tab, get rid of the default material. Add a diffuse BSDF. Add a shader to RGB and a color ramp. Change the ramp from linear to constant. Move the stops, add stops, change the colors. That's a Toon Shader. You may want to use a sun lamp, and that may work better for your scene, but I find that it doesn't normally give me the control I want over the lights, so I'm using a point light. Now we want outlines. Make a new material. Emission, black. Check backface culling. In the modifier tab, make a solidify modifier. Under normals, check flip and high quality. Under materials, make material offset 1. And there's some outlines. You might want to change the thickness. And you can stop there if you want, but let's get weird. I'm going to do some more things. I'm going to mix in an image texture. For this, I like to change the color ramp back to white and then this sort of reddish brown. We're going to add a mix shader, change it to color, and multiply, and hook it up again. Now we want to add a shader to RGB, an emission, and an image texture. Click on the image texture and press Ctrl T to get your mapping nodes. Now just select an image. We'll turn the factor all the way up so we can see what we're doing. Fancy. If you want really heavy shadows, change this to black, but I'm gonna do a more complex lighting effect. So I kind of want to keep it in the red. It gives the colors a saturation that looks like a cartoon to me. We also want to take the factor on the mix shader back a tiny bit. Duplicate the mix shader with Shift D, but change this one to screen. Duplicate these three nodes and hook them up to B. Change this to black and pull this one up. Now we can control the color of our light. You might want to make a rim light effect. Duplicate the mix shader one more time and change it to add. We need a Fresnel node and a color ramp. Set it to constant. Now we can control the area and color of the rim. With the factor on the mix node, we can control the intensity. Or just turn it off completely because I don't want that. The placement of your light is the most important part of this. So play around with it. Remember, all of these settings are meant to be messed around with, so that's a very, very simple Toon Shader. That's it.